solve the differential equation x square d square y by dx square minus x dy by dx minus 3y equals x square log x. Let us call this differential equation as equation 1. Notice that this differential equation possesses variable coefficients. Coefficient of d square y by dx square equals x square. Coefficient of dy by dx equals x. And this is of Cauchy-Euler type. Hence, in order to convert the given differential equation to differential equation with constant coefficients, we will make use of the transformation equation x equals e raised to t or t equals log x, which are exactly the same. Imposing this transformation, we have x dy by dx equals capital D acting on y, x square d square y by dx square equals capital D into d minus 1 acting on y, where d stands for differential operator with respect to independent variable t. Thus, we have equation 1 can be written as d into d minus 1 minus d minus 3 acting on y equals e raised to t the whole square multiplied to t, because x square becomes e raised to t the whole square and log x becomes t, imposing the transformation. On simplification, the LHS becomes d square minus 2d minus 3 acting on y equals e raised to 2t into t. This differential equation numbered as 2 is a differential equation with constant coefficient and has independent variable t. We have this differential equation has auxiliary equation m square minus 2m minus 3 equals 0. We obtain real and distinct roots m1 equals 3 and m2 equals minus 1. Hence, complementary function for equation 2 will be c1 e raised to negative t plus c2 e raised to 3t. In order to find out complementary function for differential equation numbered as 1, which is Cauchy-Euler type of differential equation, we have to again make use of the transformation x equals e raised to t. Thus, we have complementary function for equation 1 will be c1 multiplied to x inverse plus c2 multiplied to x cube. This is obtained by giving e raised to t equals x. We have e raised to negative t becomes x the whole raised to minus 1. Also, e raised to 3t becomes x the whole raised to 3. Now we will find out particular integral for equation 2. We have pi equals 1 by f of t acting on the RHS e raised to 2t multiplied to t, where f of d equals capital D square minus 2d minus 3. Since the input function is exponential function in terms of independent variable t multiplied to another function on independent variable t, we can take the exponential function outside the operation of f of d, but 1 by f of d will get transformed to 1 by f of d plus 2. That is, wherever d appears here in the expression of f of d, it will be replaced by d plus 2, where 2 is the coefficient of independent variable t in the exponential function. We usually replace capital D by d plus a, where a is the coefficient of independent variable in the exponential function. Thus, pi equals e raised to 2t multiplied to this operator, which acts on the input t. On simplification, this new operator becomes d square plus 2d minus 3. Since we have input of the format t raised to n, we will try to rewrite this operator as 1 plus phi of d, which will be taken to the numerator as 1 plus phi of d the whole inverse and will be expanded using binomial theorem. This operator can be written as minus 3 times minus d square plus 2d by 3 plus 1. When you take negative 3 common from outside each of this term, e raised to 2t by 3 is written as it is with the negative sign written along with the numerator. This operator, when taken to numerator, becomes 1 minus 2d by 3 plus d square by 3 the whole inverse acting on t. Since we have by binomial theorem 1 minus x the whole inverse equals 1 plus x square plus x cube plus etc., this operator when expanded becomes 1 plus 2d by 3 plus d square by 3 plus 2d by 3 plus d square by 3 the whole square plus etc. We need to consider only the first power, since the input t is having power equal to 1. Neglecting the higher powers of this operator, we have 1 multiplied to t becomes t, and when this term acts on t, we have 2 by 3 as the answer, because derivative of t equals 1, d square over t becomes 0. Therefore, pi valid for differential equation 2 will be e raised to 2t by minus 3 multiplied to t plus 2 by 3. In order to find out particular integral for equation 1, which is the Cauchy-Euler type of differential equation, we will again make use of the transformation t equals log x or x equals e raised to t. Thus, we have pi for equation 1 will be negative x square by 3 multiplied to log x plus 2 by 3. Therefore, general solution for the given Cauchy-Euler type of differential equation will be sum of complementary function and particular integral, which is c1 by x plus c2 x cube minus x square by 3 multiplied to log x plus 2 by 3.